to think of me, to plan each step so patiently, to rewrite dreams I thought I lost. Love on the cross, how kind of God, how kind of God to bring me pain. For there are things in me that pain can change. I'm not fond of tears, or how much they cost. But if the hurt is worth the price for what I lost,
well, good day, everybody. Good Friday. Good Friday means so much to us who are believers in the body of Christ. And so on this day, I greet you in the name of our Lord and our Savior, Jesus Christ. It is my prayer that on today, via the expression of our church, remembrance of what Jesus did for us, that you will have an opportunity to revisit in your spirit and in your soul all the goodness that Jesus brought to us. I said, good.
Hallelujah.
God ordered our deliverance.
I believe we're saying that again.
So it's a good Friday. So sit back and enjoy the presentation rendered by our church. And let me say thank you in advance for those who participate and who share. All things work together for the good of them who love the Lord. The Chicago Mass Choir makes it so in song. If you listen as we go forth into this presentation today, bless you and God keep you is my prayer. By the way, the flowers on the altar today are dedicated to the sacred memory of our loved ones who have gone before and to the general resurrection that we believe is ours in Christ Jesus. Actually, I believe in God the Father Almighty, the maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and he was buried. But oh, bless his name, on the third day he rose from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sits at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From then he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Church Universal, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sin, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. So on Good Friday, God is working it out for your good. Enjoy.
Easter bells ring out a message ever new. Our risen Lord brings love and peace to you and you and you.
Happy Easter.
Happy Easter.
Let's rejoice. Let's rejoice on this Easter day. Let's rejoice. Let's rejoice because Jesus is the way. Let's rejoice. Let's rejoice because we're going to win. Let's rejoice. Let's rejoice because Jesus saved us from our sin.
My name is Lynn Starr and my speech is I'm glad. I'm glad it's Easter. I'm glad Jesus came to save. I'm glad he was sent from the garden. I want to shout and sing. Jesus is alive. Jesus is alive. Jesus is alive. Jesus is alive. Happy Easter, everyone!
The Easter egg. The Easter egg is hollow, just like they found the tomb. It is meant to represent Christ who has risen for you and me.
On Easter Day, Easter lilies, can you hear what they whisper low and clear? In dewy fragrance, they unfold, their splendor sweet, their snowing gold. Every beauty-breathing bell, news of heaven has to tell. Listen to their mystic voice, hear a mortal, and rejoice. Hark their soft and heavenly chime, Christ is risen for all time. Happy Easter from Tamia Foster.
Selfishly, thy own covering, oh how you paid your life for me. Bruised, scorned, crowned her head with thorns, no greater love before for me.
I never knew of a love so You paid it all up on the cross to play and die.
Gospel singer Larniel Harris sings a song entitled, "There Stands the Cost." We hear these words, "Like a veil that has been lifted, now I see a glimpse of what the Father has for me. There beyond the splendor, a vision of the cross, and the Father calls to me, there stands the cost." Jesus died on the cross for your sins and my sins to bring us back into right relationship with God so that we can be in right relationship with each other. On the road to the cross, Jesus met and touched many people. No matter how they came, after they met Jesus, they were never the same. Travel with us on the road to the cross.
My name is John the Baptist. I was considered to be a miracle child, born childless to elderly parents. The priest Zacharias and his wife Elizabeth, my mom and Jesus were cousins. I was called to prepare the way for Jesus, to get people ready for the promised Messiah. My ministry began in the wilderness of Judea. My message was to repent and to turn back to God, because the kingdom of heaven was near. I baptized people with water to show that their hearts and lives have changed, but the one who follows me would baptize them with the Holy Spirit and fire. Tough, I felt unworthy. I baptized Jesus in the Jordan River. Heaven opened and God's Spirit came down like a dove, and a voice from heaven said, "This is my Son, who I love, and I am pleased with him."
My name is not mentioned in the Bible, nor were the names of my four friends who went out of their way to get me in the presence of Jesus. Jesus was in Capernaum, healing, teaching, and preaching. The crowd was so large that there was no space in the house. It was so crowded around the house that there was no room left. So my four friends lifted me up on the building, dug a hole in the roof, and lowered me in front of Jesus. Jesus saw my friend Faith. He said, "Son, your sins are forgiven." Jesus came to save us from our sins because sin separates us from Jesus and God. Now, some teachers of the law thought that only God can forgive sin. Jesus asked, "Which is easier to say to this paralyzed man, 'Your sins are forgiven,' or 'Get up, take your mat, and walk'? But I want you to know that the Son of Man has authority on earth to forgive sins. So he said to me, 'Take your mat and go home.' I got up, took my mat, and walked out in front of all of them. This amazed everyone and praised God, saying, 'We have never seen anything like this.'"
I am a Samaritan woman that met Jesus at Jacob's Well. My name is not mentioned in the book because my name is not important. What is important is that I met a man named Jesus. Jews and Samaritans did not talk to each other, yet Jesus asked me, a woman, for a drink of water. As I was talking to this Jewish man, I realized that this man is no ordinary man. He knew everything about me and offered me spiritual water to quench my thirst. I was so excited to meet Jesus that I left my watering can and went to the town to tell everyone, "Come meet the man who knew everything about me. Is this not the Christ?"
My name was not mentioned in the Bible, in the book of Luke, because my name is not important. I was a guilty thing hanging on the right side of Jesus. The Messiah was in the middle. The word Messiah means Savior, because Jesus, who was the one guilty of nothing, took on the punishment of all my guilt just to save me from dying and living forever in hell. Hanging on the cross, I knew there was something special about Jesus because he cared about everyone else in the crowd screaming, "Kill him." I asked him to remember me when he returned into his Father's kingdom. When he left earth to return back to heaven to reign with God his Father. The words he said changed my life. I'll tell you the truth. Today, you will be with me in paradise.
Good morning and happy Holy Week from the Grand Chapel AME Church, Young Adult Church School class and friends. Holy Week is the week between Palm Sunday and Easter. It is also called the Great Week because great deeds were done by God during this week. Please watch and rejoice as we try to take you on a journey through Holy Week.
In early Christianity, the egg symbolized fertility and renewal. The yolk is said to represent Christ. Emergence from the tomb. Eggs were painted red to represent the blood that Christ shed on the cross. Happy Resurrection Day.
Dear God and Lord of Life, you who call forth from the darkness all those who love you, we rejoice on this Easter Sunday in the resurrection from the dead of our Lord Jesus Christ. May the risen Christ, our Lord and Savior, be our guide as we celebrate his resurrection with his Easter prayer. Amen.
To a word from God. For what I received, I passed on to you as of first importance, that Christ died for our sins according to the scriptures, that he was buried, that he was raised on the third day according to the scriptures.
Approached Jerusalem and came to Bethphage on the Mount of Olives, Jesus sent two disciples, saying to them,
"Go to the village ahead of us, and at once you will find a donkey tied there with its coat. Untie them and bring them to me. If anyone asks you what you're doing, say that the Lord needs them, and he will send them back right away."
Took place to fulfill what was spoken through the prophet, saying to daughter Zion, "See, your king comes to you, gentle, and riding on a donkey, on a colt, the foal of a donkey." Disciples went and did as Jesus had instructed them. They brought the donkey and the colt and placed their cloaks on them for Jesus to sit on. A very large crowd spread their cloaks on the road, while others cut branches from the trees and spread them on the road. The crowds that went ahead of him and those that followed shouted, "Hosanna, the Son of David!
Oh,
Jerusalem, the whole city was stirred and asked, "Who is this?" The crowd answered, "This is Jesus."
God and cast all out them that stole out of the temple and overthrew the pastors of the money changers and the thief of them that sold doves and said unto them,
"It is written, my house shall be the house of prayer, but yet you have turned into a house of thieves."
In the morning, as he was on his way back to the city, he was hungry. Seeing a fig tree by the road, he went up to it, but found nothing on it except leaves. Then he said to it,
"May you never bear fruit."
When the disciples saw this, they were amazed. "How did the fig tree wither so quickly?" they asked. Jesus replied,
"If you have faith and doubt not, you too can make this mountain move. He said, move this mountain to the sea, it shall move. If you have faith the size of mustard seed, you can speak to the mulberry tree, and it shall be removed."
Evening came. Jesus was reclining at the table with the 12. And while they were eating, he said,
"Truth I say to you, the one of you shall betray me."
They were very sad and began to say to him one after the other,
"Is it our Lord?
Is it our Lord?"
"Not me."
Jesus replied,
"He that dipped his hand with me in the dish, the same shall betray me."
"Sure not I, Rabbi."
That's it.
While they were eating, Jesus took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying,
"This is my body."
Then he took a cup, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying,
"Drink ye all of it, for this is my blood."
On one of the days leading up to his crucifixion, Jesus wanted to go to the Garden of Gethsemane to pray. While there, Jesus paused his prayer to make sure that his disciples knew how important it was that they stay alert and watch their surroundings. As the night progressed, Jesus and his disciples were approached by a group, including one of his own disciples, Judas. The group had one agenda: to identify Jesus. Judas indicated Jesus' presence with a kiss, and Jesus was arrested.
After they had beaten him all night, they led him away to be crucified. They compelled a man named Simon to bear his cross. They led him to the place called the Skull, in the Hebrew, Golgotha. There he would be crucified with two other, one on each side and Jesus in the middle. Jesus' mother and his mother's sister, and Mary, the wife of Cleophas, and Mary Magdalene stood at the foot of the cross. When Jesus saw his mother and the sight that he loved, he said, woman, behold thy son. And said to the disciple, behold thy mother. And that disciple took him to his home thereafter. Jesus knew that all things was accomplished. He said, I thirst. And they gave him they dipped a sponge in vinegar, put it on a hyssop, and gave it to him. After he received the vinegar, he said, it's finished. And he bowed his head and gave up the ghost.
On a hill far away stood an old rugged cross, an emblem of suffering and shame. And I love that old cross for the dearest and best. For a world of lost sinners was slain.
Who said to the women, do not be afraid, for I know that you are looking for Jesus, who was crucified. He is not here. He has risen, just as he said. Come and see the place where he lay. Then go quickly and tell his disciples, he has risen from the dead and is going ahead of you into Galilee. There you will see him. Now I have told you. So the women hurried away from the tomb, afraid yet filled with joy, and ran to tell his disciples. Suddenly, Jesus met them.
Greeting,
he said. They came to him, clasped his feet, and worshipped him.
Be not afraid. Go tell my brother to meet me in Galilee. There they will see me.
Thank you for going on this journey with us through Holy Week. Because of all the good deeds done this week, it's also called Great Deeds Week. Beginning with Jesus' triumphant entry into Jerusalem, him cleansing the temple, cursing the fig tree, praying in the Garden of Gethsemane, carrying the old rugged cross, even to the crucifixion and the grave, and the triumphant resurrection day. We've all sinned and deserve God's judgment. God the Father sent his only Son to satisfy that judgment for those who believe in him. Jesus, the Creator and eternal Son of God, who lived a sinless life, loves us so much that he died for our sins, taking the punishment that we deserve, was buried and rose from the dead. If you truly believe and trust this in your heart, receiving Jesus alone as your Savior, declaring Jesus is Lord, you will be saved from judgment and spend eternity with God in heaven. Thanks to all who participated, especially to our out-of-town guests, Kennedy McReynolds in Sacramento, California, Tiffany Sims and family in Miamisburg, Ohio, and Justin McReynolds in Winter Park, Florida. Thank you. Good evening.
May your struggle keep you near the cross, and may your troubles show that you need God, and may your battles in the way they should, and may your bad days prove that God is good, and may your whole life prove that God is good.
See, may your struggles keep you near the cross, and may your troubles
Thank y'all so much for coming out. May your bad days prove that God is good. May your whole life prove that God is good. See, may your bad days prove that God is good. Come on. May your whole life, yeah.